CGPA is important in compares to how busy I have been the past 1 year. Hello, hello, hello guys. Welcome back to my channel. I am Shireen. If you do not know me, I study at NUJS Kolkata. I just completed my first year of law school and it was just such a journey. So today's video is essentially me telling you everything that I wish somebody would have sat me down and told me before I started law at NUJS. Like, just somebody would have told me, this is what is important, Shireen. Don't cry over these matters. These are your priorities. If somebody would have just sat me down and told me all these things, been that big sister, I would have been so grateful. So yeah, I didn't have one, but you get one, right? So subscribe definitely if you want to see more CLAT and NLU based content. I will be sharing tons of it. I have just like so much great content planned, so definitely subscribe to my channel if you want to keep watching videos by me. And without any further ado, let us get started with all the things I wish I knew before I joined law school. Okay, a small interjection, but I know a lot of you watching this video are CLAT aspirants, and I have just like three very quick tips to help you to succeed in CLAT. First is to start as early as possible. Second is to give your mocks very seriously and diligently. And third is to have a proper organized study plan. Now, today's video is kindly sponsored by Physicswala, and they're all offering this to you in one bundle at an extremely reduced price. Personally, I love working with this brand because their prices are some of the lowest you will find in CLAT coaching in the market. You can go and do your research. And they have launched two additional batches, as well as they have slashed their prices for all their ongoing batches by a large margin. So from the 11th of May to the 15th of May. So if you want planning to purchase or enroll yourself in any coaching institute, you can do that. Plus, it's a completely online coaching, so you don't really have to go anywhere and you can do it from the comfort of your home. So they have launched two batches which are called the CLAT Zenith batches for people who are currently in class 11 or give CLAT next year, so CLAT 2026 essentially. So they have first their CLAT Zenith 2026 batch, which originally retails for 17,999, but you have a discount of $1,500 and you get it for $16,499. Now in this, you get to cover the entire syllabus of CLAT and ELIT. You also get 500 hours of live lectures, mock tests, sectional tests, as well as current affair monthly magazines and doubt solving classes as well. They also have a Zenith Pro batch, which retails for originally 24,999, which has been reduced to 23,499. And here you not just get to cover the syllabus of CLAT and ELIT, but also all other law entrance exams, and you get a lot more mock tests and a lot more material to work with. They also have discounts for the current batch who will give CLAT 2025. So for you guys, there is the CLAT Risers 2025 batch, which originally retails for 8,999, but in the discount it's 7,499. So there you get to cover the syllabus of CLAT and ELIT. So you can also purchase the Pro course, where you get, apart from CLAT and ELIT, other law entrance exam coaching as well. At Pro 2025 batch and the CLAT Zenith Pro 2026 batch is personally what I would recommend, especially if you want to give like all of the other law entrance exams. Also, you get way more additional materials. So, and that is not all, guys. With my code SH500, you get additional 500 rupees off apart from the discounts that you're getting. So definitely, if you plan on purchasing anything from Physicswala, definitely use my code. That will let them know that I have sent you their way, and also you will get an additional discount. So it's a win-win situation for both of us. Now let's get back to the main video. So the first thing, and this is like really important, is be prepared for law school to be all freaking consuming. Like, you are gonna be so busy, you have no idea. Like, if you thought ki boards bahut zyada difficult thi, or you know, competitive exams difficult thi, law school is another ball game altogether. You will be stretched in all different directions at the same time. आप बोर्ड्स के टाइम पे या कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम के टाइम पे आपका सिर्फ सिंगुलर फोकस था कि मुझे ये पास करना है, ये एग्जाम करना है, यहाँ क्रैक करना है. एट लॉ स्कूल यू विल हैव एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर्स, यू विल हैव योर एकेडमिक प्रेशर, उसके साथ साथ आपको प्रोजेक्ट्स बनानी पड़ेंगे, यू माइट बी अ पार्ट ऑफ सोसाइटीज एंड कमिटीज, यू माइट हैव वर्क फॉर ऑल दोज थिंग्स. लॉ स्कूल इज गोना बी सो फ्रिकिंग बिजी. लाइक a regular college doesn't compare to law school, especially if you come to like a really good law school where academic pressure is so high, and also like people are really hardworking here. So even if you don't want to study per se, like when you look at other people sitting in the library and studying, you are going to want to study as well. And I remember like my parents used to get like super frustrated ki you don't have time for any family engagements, you don't have time to go anywhere, you're literally just sitting in front of your desk and just like writing and typing and researching, like that's literally all you have to do, and be very frustrating unless and until you of course love the work. Personally, I love the research and like, you know, the writing and everything. So I don't mind it that much. But yeah, it's literally like I have been like in my laptop like 7 to 8 hours in a day just sitting and like writing stuff. Like a large part of law school is just going to be that. So if this is something that you don't think you can see yourself doing, then perhaps reconsider this decision, because law school is really, really one of the craziest and most busy times of your life ever. Like nothing compares to how busy I have been the past 1 year. Now coming to the second thing, which is basically do not let imposter syndrome scare you. It is okay to experience failure. Okay, so like kind of a story time. So main science background se hoon, and when I went for my first like week of class at NUJS, a lot of people were from like arts background. They had done subjects like pol science and sociology and stuff, but I just saw a lot of students having so much more knowledge. Like in the first week, everybody, you know, is like really excited and everybody wants to show that, hey, I have come with, you know, a lot of merit and stuff. So everybody's like raising their hands, talking about Lenin and like Marxism and stuff, and I'm sitting there like, yeah, I just know these concepts like in very small details. Mujhe to kuch pata bhi nahi hai sab ke baare mein. Please hold back and understand that it's completely okay if you don't know anything. You might think that those people knowing something means they are so ahead of the game, you will never be able to compete with them. That's absolutely not true at all. Do not let imposter syndrome scare you. Do not let other people ki, oh, iska to itna rank hai, inka to itna rank hai, iska matlab I will never be able to compete with them. That's not at all true. Once you enter your particular college, that's it. Like, you belong there. You don't have to second guess your right to space in that place. And trust me, just because other people sound smarter doesn't mean necessarily that you won't get a level playing field. Of course, there will be a lot of failures. There will be people who will be better than you in certain aspects and stuff like that. That is completely there. But and there will be things in which you are very good at compared to other people. So please remember that and do not let imposter syndrome scare you. The first week of college, I was so scared, like, oh my god, everybody knows everything. But yeah, it's fine. I did pretty well by the end of the year, and I definitely think after that I did not feel like I didn't belong. Right, and third, and this is like very conflicting advice that you will hear from like everyone, right? That grades are not important, your CGPA does not matter, what matters is how much you learn and stuff like that. Now here's the thing, I just want to like burst your bubble about this, only reason because I just want to give you a harsh reality check. And this is literally the truth of law schools in India as of right now, I can definitely tell you. And that is that grades are very, very, very important. And CGPA is very important. And please understand that aapke jo school mein tha na, ki agar aap class 10 mein jitna marks hai, aapke class 11 mein, that doesn't get carried forward, right? Or 11 ke marks 12 mein nahi jaate. But in college, all 5 years, every semester is going to count towards your final CGPA. So please, please remember this aspect. So if you get really low marks in one of your semesters, then it will impact your overall grades, right? And your batch rank as well. Am I telling you ki you have to be batch rank one? Absolutely not. All I'm saying is try to at least be average in your batch, so that when recruiters come, when you go for internships, you do not lose out opportunities. Because trust me when I say this, while CGPA doesn't matter, like as such, like aisa nahi hai ki if you're batch rank 2, somebody's batch rank 1 and somebody's like batch rank 10, that there's going to be some huge amount of like differentiation between those two people. But what ends up happening, for placements, a lot of companies, they will come and say, only bring people like above 7 GPA, I want to interview only those people, right? So there's like barriers that are often created by certain demarcations, ki is GPA ke upar hi bhejo, or you know, certain law firm will ask for your batch rank and stuff. You have to put your batch rank even in your CV. So just having one that is slightly impressive or even like average really, really helps compared to if you get one that is very below average. And it might just kill some of your opportunities, and would really, really suck if you work a lot, especially towards the later end of your law career. But like in the first year or something, you've just gotten really bad marks, that has overall impacted your CGPA. Again, don't make CGPA your entire bread and butter and think ki ye hai mujhe to sirf padhai karna hai. That's not what I'm saying. I am just saying that it is important. It is not as useless as often you will get you know, certain people saying on YouTube. Aisa nahi hota hai. CGPA is important, and it is something that is often considered, especially when we are talking about placements and jobs and internships at places. The fourth thing is, and this is really important, personally I didn't make this mistake, but a lot of my batchmates did, which is they've thought that, you know, first year hai, so I'm just going to chill back thoda and I will try everything in my second year. So please understand, your first year is that 1 year where you have to try everything. I know it can get overwhelming, but try your hand at everything. Go for ideas, go for moods, go for debates, go and do every freaking thing possible under the sun. And the reason for that is very simply, unless you do it, you will not understand. Just by observing from a distance, you will not be able to understand what you're actually made for. Like, there were so many things that I thought I would not be able to do, but I ended up getting pretty good results out of it. The reason I'm saying this is because otherwise you're going to regret it in the second year. Because see, first year mein, you are in the best level playing field of your life. Everybody is in the same place. Everybody has almost no idea in the beginning ke kya hota hai, mood, what are moods, what are ideas. Nobody really has that great of an idea, right? But once you go to your second year, some of your batchmates might have gone to international competitions. Some of your batchmates might have gone and won some really great stuff, and they might have gotten a lot of experience. So then competing with them in second year in the internals just becomes so much more difficult to the internals of your first year, where you might have a much more level playing field and you might get a good mood to go to, or a good ADL competition to go through the internal allocation. And please remember that 5 years is not a really big time. So once you go to your third, fourth year, the most important thing that you're going to think about is your placement or your job or whatever future mein aapko karna hai, right? At that point, like fourth year, third years, you are not going to see a lot of people like doing extracurriculars. Most of them are now focused on getting an internship, getting a job, securing those things become more important. So your first, second and third year are probably the only 3 years where you actually have that time to go and do all those extracurriculars, because fourth year mein jaake the most important thing is jobs, because at the end of the fourth year you have your day zero and your placement season. Fifth year jo hota hai wo bahut chill year hota hai for most people. Once you get a job, you just sit back and just do studies. Most people don't even take part in anything at all, unless they want to try something, that's a different thing. But most people are just chilling in their fifth year, and fourth year tak hi sari cheeze hoti hai. And fourth year also the most important part is like job dhoondna. So please remember all these aspects. You might think 5 years is a really long time, but there's just like different focuses you're gonna have throughout the years. So agar kuch try karna hai to first year se hi start kar do. Now the fifth point, and this is like really important, and you might think this is so out of place, but try to be a good humble person, right? So in law school we have this term called CT, which basically means cutthroat, right? So a cutthroat is somebody like who you know, who doesn't want to share their notes, who's not very helpful, who will take help from you but will never return the favor. Law school is a very collaborative process, and there's a lot of group work that you will be expected to. Like just last semester I had like 2 freaking presentations which were group presentations. We had to write like a group essay for our English project. Even like within like moot internals and stuff, you make informal alliances to share researches and stuff. And if you're somebody who's arrogant, who is somebody who's considered to be CT by other people of your batch, you're not going to find good people to work with. Like, I know mere batch se mujhe kin kin logo se kabhi work nahi karna hai, because I know there are people who are going to take my help but not return my help. So everybody knows, and trust me, like if you think that people will not get to know, no, I know the people in my batch I don't want to work with, and everybody knows. Okay, so these kind of news spread very fast, so don't be arrogant, don't be CT. The most toppers of my batch jitna maine dekha hai are people who help with their notes so much. And the thing is, agar aap hard work karte ho na, nobody is going to take away from that achievement of yours. You cannot go through 5 years of law school being alone or having a bad reputation. This is not school, like your school ends, you're not going to meet these people. No, you're going to meet these people forever. So starting at a bad note is not recommended at all. So be humble, be kind, do not be arrogant. If your batchmates ask you for help, help them so that when the time comes, you also get their help as well, right? So yeah, another sixth point, and this is also really important, which is to focus on your soft skills as well. So law school mein aapko bahut sari hard skills sikhai jayenge, write a legal research paper, how to understand statutes, and like you will have a lot of proper like hard skill trainings being done at law school. But soft skills are equally important, right? Like what kind of soft skills am I speaking about? Networking, having good communication skills, being having critical thinking skills, you know, having good rapport with your seniors. These are all things which are so important. Like I remember I went to this competition a couple of days back, and there were these judges who had judged my round, and after that we had the lunch. So I went there and I spoke to them, and I told them this was my first mediation competition, and they were like really impressed with my performance. So spoke to them, I added them on LinkedIn. Now you might think what is the big deal about all these, but the thing is these are really really important things, because when you're interacting with anybody, especially from the field that you are going to go into in the future, please remember these are people you never know who is going to come to your help, right? So having a good interaction with your seniors is also very very important. And not everything is about like transaction, right? I'm not saying only do it because it's of help to you. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying having good connections just really really helps in the longer run. And it's not like that only I'm taking advantage of everyone's good connections. I am also a good connection for somebody. Like, a lot of people text me related to NUJS, any work that they have with the college. A lot of people text me and I, you know, forward them the numbers of relevant people or whatever it is that they want, right? So doing this is really how the industry sort of works. So please focus on your networking skills. So the seventh tip, and this is, do not always be a part of a herd, right? So in law school, you will often hear, oh, moots are the most important thing, or ADR is the most important activity, or, you know, getting into this particular committee is the most important thing. And yes, often sometimes these things are very cool and very amazing, but that doesn't always mean you have to be a part of a herd. So I'll tell you my story in my first year. So when I went, and I didn't get selected into any committees at college. So it was honestly very heartbreaking, because I was like, why are other people in my batch getting into committees and society and all, and I'm not getting into anything? Like, I, something must be wrong with me, right? So I went into like full self-sabotage, imposter syndrome mode, and I ended up not getting into any committees. But there is a cloud to the silver lining, of course. So there was this Center for Media Law that opened its application, so I just ended up like going and was like, okay, fine, I'll just like put my CV and an SOP, like, let's see. And I ended up being the only first year who got selected, and it is honestly one of the best experiences that I've had. I've worked so much, like a research internship under this project, and again, as I said, I didn't follow the herd. This wasn't really something that anybody else, I guess, in my batch even applied. It was mostly the seniors. They applied under their technical team, because they wanted people who could understand like thoda sa technology for like tracking and stuff of news and stuff. And I was good at coding, really technological advanced compared to like, I guess, other people in law. So I applied and I got it. I was the only person who got it, and I have learned so much in that place. So yeah, like, do not be part of the herd. Do your own thing as well. And this is something you want to note, especially if you come to a good college. You're going to see your batchmates doing things of their own. So many of my batchmates, you know, they teach CLAT aspirants. I have this YouTube channel. There's so many other things that people are doing which are not necessarily a part of college per se, or academics, or like law related even. So it's good to have hobbies, and it's good to not always be a part of the herd within college, and even like things outside the legal sphere as well. The next tip that I have is, now these are like the last two tips are more like social life tips, but it is that do not wait for deadlines to finish before going out and enjoying your life. So this is such an important tip. I wish somebody would have told this to me in first semester. Second semester tak aate aate main samajh gayi thi. But law school, your life is just going to be deadlines after deadlines. Take care, aapko ek deadline ke baad ek deadline. Like, that's how life is going to be. You need to learn time management, period. Okay, if you cannot manage your time and you just chase deadlines, you're never going to enjoy your life. Like, 5 years aise chala jayega, you will literally be just cooped up in your college. You will not explore the city you are in, you will not explore anything, you will not even be able to make friends properly because you're just focused on deadlines. Please do not do that. Go out and enjoy your life, making sure that you don't miss the deadlines. So just don't wait for all deadlines to finish, for that magical day to come, because by the time you finish the deadlines, you will have new deadlines. So don't do all that. Go and enjoy your life, but make sure that you finish your work. So please learn time management. This is one of the most important skills that you need to learn to ace in law school, right? Ninth point, and this is like the last point that I have, be careful who you trust and be careful with your freedom, right? So law school mein aapko bahut freedom milti hai, especially at NUJS. Like, There's hardly any curfew. You get to do whatever you want. And honestly, with great power comes really great responsibilities, right? Please remember that people will come from all sorts of backgrounds, all sorts of places. And you have to remember that har insaan ke saath aapki mental matching nahi hogi. Har insaan ke saath aapki opinions match nahi karenge, and there you will be shocked at some of the things that you'll see your batchmates and seniors and all pulling, and you'll be like, oh my god, how can anyone do that, right? So there's going to be like massive cultural differences between you and other people, because hum sab apne apne way and apne apne upbringing ko leke aate hai, right? And that's in a good way, because you have so much of diversity, but it's also sometimes it can lead you to some very disastrous consequences, because you don't realize what is right and wrong, and you're just like finding things cool, and you go and you just go astray. Don't do that, okay? It's very easy to get distracted. Please keep yourself grounded and remember why you have come. Like, if you've worked so hard to come and study at a college, understand the weight of how much you have worked to come here. Please remember that and don't ruin your future over it, right? So this is really important for anyone watching this video. And when it comes to people and friends and making friends and trusting friends, please remember that ek mahine, do mahine se aap kisi ko judge nahi kar sakte. It has to at least be a good 5 to 6 months before you can actually understand. So I'm not saying don't be friends with people in the first month of your college. Of course, be friends. Of course, go out. But be cautious about who you're hanging out with, because I have seen lots of things. I have seen people, you know, like who are considered to be best friends just bitching about each other at their back. So, aise bahut sari situations hoti hai. So, yeah, just like be careful before you spill your deepest, darkest secrets, before you really trust someone with your literal life. Think about the consequence. It might seem like, oh, everybody else is having such great friendships. Trust me, by the end of first sem, second sem, aate aate, sab dosti toot jaati ho. So be a little careful about who you're trusting, and thoda sa dekh ke hi trust karna, theek hai? So yeah, that is everything I wanted to tell you guys. I hope you enjoy this video. Thank you so much. Like and subscribe to this channel, and definitely comment down if you agree to what I said, and if you found this video helpful. So thank you so much. Bye.